Hello fellow nerds. In this video we're going to make a complete refillable glow stick. Making the container is fairly easy. First you need a length of suitable tubing. I'm using vinyl for clarity, but vinyl is easily stained by the dyes. Polyethylene or polypropylene would give better results. Second, you need compression fittings and caps that fit your tubing. I'm using brass for a steampunk style, but you can use other types if you desire. Simply assemble it together with Teflon tape and tighten it as hard as you can. Here is the finished product, a refillable container for the glow stick fluid. Now the next part is to make the hydrogen peroxide ampoule. To do this, first get a disposable glass pipette. These are quite cheap and can be bought online. Next, using a torch, melt the pointy end down to seal it from leaking. This is called flame sealing. Wait until the tube cools to room temperature. When it's cool, fill the tube with 30% hydrogen peroxide, but leave about an inch empty from the top. You need this gap so the peroxide doesn't boil from the heat when you flame seal it later. Once it is filled, flame seal the top. I make this look easy because I've done this sort of thing hundreds of times. If this is your first time, you might get popping, bubbling, or even shattering of your glass due to uneven heating. I recommend practicing with water-filled tubes until you get the hang of it. Wear eye protection in case your tubes shatter, and always be careful when working with torches. Here is the finished product, a flame-sealed hydrogen peroxide ampoule. Now we make the glow fluid. First, we use the ethyl phthalate solvent to dissolve the chemicals. Next, we have sodium acetate and TCPO. Then we have our dye, which is 9,10 bisphenylethyl anthracene for a green color. Mix them all very generously and fill the container. A perceptive viewer will notice we use a different solvent from the ethyl acetate we use in our previous videos. Although diethyl phthalate is more expensive and much harder to get than ethyl acetate, it gives a brighter and longer lasting light than ethyl acetate, which is what you want in a glow stick. Now that the container is filled, very carefully drop in the hydrogen peroxide ampoule. Cap it off. And now you have a complete refillable glow stick. Let's test this baby out. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this video informative, even if you're not able to replicate it yourself. So please, subscribe, rate, and comment.